Hello, and welcome to the TI Precision Lab series on currents in amplifiers. My name is Patrick Simmons, and I'm an applications engineer in the current position sensing product line. In this video, we will broach the topic of debug, beginning with board layout. As you may have seen in our other videos, there are several sources of error that can make the measured output deviate from the ideal output. Aside from the shunt tolerance, these are all inherent to the device and cannot be avoided. However, there is another set of errors that hinge on the user. These include improper layout, probe placement, solder issues, overlooking device specifications, downstream circuitry, equipment, and damaging the device. In the subsequent video series, we will cover a large yet non-exhaustive list of scenarios that lead to results that the untrained eye may overlook. We will then point to the source of error and provide a tip on how to avoid such an error. For this particular video, we will focus on errors related to improper layout. Our first case study results from us trying to measure 10 amps across a milliohm shunt. Based off of our calculations, we expect the output should be roughly 200 millivolts reference to ground. However, when we take measurements with our multimeters, we observe something that defies expectation. While our input measurement is 10 millivolts, our output is way off at 1.286 volts. What could be the issue here? Our schematic looks correct. Do we have a defective or damaged part? Let's look at some more details. Here is the board layout along with where we are probing. Now we can see the source of our error, the board trace. The N-minus board trace is actually in the direct path of the load and therefore is in series with R shunt. As shunts typically have small resistances, any series trace resistance can significantly increase the differential sense voltage detected by the current shunt monitor and therefore increase the output of the device. In this particular case, we calculate the series trace resistance to be 5.43 milliohms, which leads to 64.3 millivolts being measured by the INA185, thereby making the INA185 output 1.286 volts. Now let's look at another case. Here we have one of our digital power monitor devices, the INA226, measuring some load. And yet again, we are getting a discrepancy between the measured input and the expected output. As the schematic yet again looks flawless, we decide to take a closer look at the board layout. Based off the prior case, can you see what the issue might be? If you guessed this trace from node B to node A would contribute error because it is in series with R shunt and contributes to the sensed voltage potential, you are correct. However, there are some other details to consider. The paths from the shunt to the input pins are not equal. This imbalance in trace length can contribute error due to the input bias current sunk into the device input pins, especially as the traces get longer and the difference in their lengths becomes greater. Also, the impedance from B bus to ground is not equivalent to N plus to ground, thereby pulling more input bias current across the unequal input traces. To avoid these issues when doing your layout, use differential pair routing for your sense inputs as this should inherently maintain equal resistance for both traces. Also, do not route your sense input trace through B-bus. So, having seen two instances of improper layout, you might ask, what does good layout look like? Here on the left, we show three different ways to lay out shunt traces. On the left, we have a relatively small shunt, where the input trace is tapped directly at the shunt pads. In the middle example, we have a slightly bigger shunt, which allows us to tap into the shunt pad side, facing into the shunt. The last approach on the right shows a resistor with dedicated sensing connection pads. You may hear these pads referred to as Kelvin connections. The basic goal of a Kelvin connection is to remove the sensing connection from the main path of current flow, which is what all of these recommended layouts do. Dedicated Kelvin sense connections become extremely important for high current, low R shunt applications because the solder can add resistance to the connection path. As for the traces between the shunt and the current monitor, we recommend that both traces be symmetric, Additionally, for high-side sensing with power monitors that are not preceded by an input filter, we recommend the bus pin connected as such. This allows any current sunk through the bus pin to be detected in the current measurement. Then, the actual bus voltage can be determined by summing both the VBUS and VSENSE voltages. As stated in the opening, layout can be a source of error and may need to be assessed when performing debug. Layout is particularly important due to shunt resistors having resistance on an order of magnitude similar to board traces. The best way to eliminate any impact of board trace resistance is with Kelvin connections and symmetric input traces, which requires vigilance when wiring based on board net names. That concludes this video. Thank you for watching. Please try the quiz to check your understanding of the content. For more information and videos on CurrentSense amplifiers, please visit ti.com/currentsense.